forecast.
The approaching storm could cause dangerous road conditions, so crews with the State Department of Transportation are gearing up for a busy 24 hours. Action 7 News reporter Todd Unger is live with more.
Shelley, it's unlikely you'll see any crews actually out in the next few hours, but when you get in that 2 a.m., 4 a.m. hour, and of course, depending on what's happening here on the roads, you could see those crews out in full force across the entire state. We all remember what happened a couple of weekends ago up there in Santa Fe. It was a mess. We were actually up there. Half a dozen accidents, one of them fatal, when the roads just frankly weren't cleared back quickly, specifically along I-25. This time around here in the metro, there are about 40 trucks and crews ready here alone to put down that salt and cinder mix with upwards of 9 cubic yards in each truck.
They can make a few runs, they'll come back, load up again, hit it again, depending on what's going on out there, and then they'll go back and slough off whatever slushed up to the sides.
So here's the big question. What areas around town should you really watch? Well, just like last year when we experienced those December storms, travel to the west along I-40 and then certainly in higher elevations like Placitas or the East Mountains will be the areas that will be the most affected. And of course, for the very latest on this storm, you can watch more in the morning, tomorrow morning right here on Channel 7. For right now, reporting live along I-25, I'm Todd Unger, KOAT Action.